start out, we see all these people together, they're friends, their improv sessions are legitimately funny. And this group, these six people, they have this chemistry, even off stage, where they are all just together, and there's just a joy to it. When one of them makes it onto a popular sketch show, and he leaves the group, it does kind of hurt the vibe of the group a little bit. It's fascinating to see all these characters be affected by it in different ways. See one character be forced to reject his friends, and it's very upsetting, but it makes sense. It makes way for a lot of really strong human drama. Keegan-Michael Key plays the member of the comedy troupe who gets in. He is the star, he is now the envy of all of his friends. And it makes sense that he'd be the one to make it. He's tall, he's charismatic, he's funny, he's got it all. But his girlfriend, who is also supposed to make it, didn't show up at her audition, so he's got to deal with that. His friends want to be writers on this sketch show, and they're all like, hey, can you get me in? Can you get me in? And he's got to deal with that. Keegan-Michael Key does a great job portraying this character that has to toe the line between I'm this person's friend and I need this person to leave me alone. He does a great job portraying the emotions of a man trying to hold on to his relationship. Gillian Jacobs plays Keegan-Michael Key's girlfriend, brilliantly. Had her shot to be on the Saturday Night Live sketch show thing, but she chose not to. She chose to reject the audition. She didn't go to it. She's comfortable where she is. She's happy doing the improv with her friends. And you totally understand it. Gillian Jacobs, as always, does a great job of fighting against the norm, fighting against this idea that you gotta be ambitious and go for it. She asks the question, why would I want to be on some stupid show that's less funny than me hanging out with my friends? And she's right to ask that question. Mike Birbiglia plays a 36-year-old improv teacher who's got a lot of baggage. He sleeps with his students, he's always complaining about how he could never make it. And he's able to get away with all this because, you know, he's funny. But underneath this guy who likes to tell jokes and have fun, he is kind of this pathetic little blob. And Mike Birbiglia gives a great, subtle, and layered performance as this sad comedian who just didn't quite make it. Kate Micucci brings this quirky air to the film because she's an artist, she likes to draw as well as be an improvisational comedian. She helps to add to this theme of the movie of no one wants you. You're not gonna make it. She might be talented, fun, and likable, but that doesn't matter because in show business she just can't make it. Chris Gethard plays a sad sack, nerdy comedian who has issues with his dad. Chris's dad is financially savvy, he's into real estate, while Chris is sort of just drifting through life. You know, he's gotta go from job to job, just trying to make a life as a comedian. And then one day his dad gets into a horrible motorcycle accident. And Chris Gethard's performance, when he finds out about this, his reaction to it, is so brilliant. Totally feel for him, and you feel this attachment that he has to his dad. And when he tells the rest of the group, you see the relationship that this group has. You see that when something horrible happens to one of them, they're all there for that person. They care about each other. They have this important relationship with each other. They're almost a family. And we see that they deal with tragedy through comedy. And it helps their comedy, and it's fascinating to see them deal with this stuff in this way. More importantly, Chris Gethard, as this nerdy comedian, just feels so right for the group. You can tell that he's a little bit shy of a person, but the way that the group accepts him, it just, there's something heartwarming about it. And there's something about seeing him perform on stage that just warms your heart. This is a fascinating look into the darker side of show business, where the people don't make it, the people fail. And we get to see how one of them achieving fame hurts their relationships, we get to see how they make these big changes in their lives. This is not a comedy, this is a drama with characters that are very funny themselves. And they're these interesting people with different perspectives, and it's just a joy to see them interact. when the movie wants to hit you hard emotionally, it completely succeeds. It doesn't show you the fantasy of show business. It shows you the harsh realities of life. But it also shows you how people move on, how people figure a way to keep going after they fail, how people can be happy. It's a painful story, but it's also an optimistic one. It's an extremely well-written and well-acted drama with lots of humorous moments and likable, interesting characters. I'm gonna give Don't Think Twice an A.